I mean, I think probably the biggest challenge with being a baritone is dealing with the immense amount of jealousy in our organization.
Absolutely. And when the bass sounds good, it's not because of the bass. It's because of the baritone. Yeah.
Emmanuel, they seem to be suggesting that really it's the connective tissue that you provide. And without that, like the grout between tiles, all of the requisite tiles would fly off into space, completely untethered from anything logical or good.
Yeah, I think that's pretty much it.
He's from Sweden.
Of course he is. Officially,
Johnny.
Mike, Johnny.
Emmanuel.
Emmanuel.
Darren.
And Darren, and they have agreed to, I think you're going to teach me, a baritone tag or something.
Yeah.
And I am going to confirm a theory that I remember from my old days in the hobby, wherein baritones all basically sing the garbage.
Anyway.
You know, Sonny Boy.
Do you know the baritone to it?
How hard can it be? The one I remember. Sonny Boy. You know, I never cared for that kid. This is the dirty job right now. A baritone on one knee, holding the microphone out, hoping and praying that something interesting happens.
That's right.
Sweet and lovely, that's what you are to me.
Is this what we should sing in front of men?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. I'm good. Okay, good, good.
We don't have to.
No, I'm good with this. I'm good with this. It's just the way you're looking at me, man. I'm right here with you.
Okay. We're just connecting.
It's good. It's not weird at all. It's good.
The honorary membership is presented to those who have had a significant impact on barbershop or a cappella singing, as well as those individuals or groups who, through their celebrity, bring positive awareness or attention to the Barbershop Harmony Society. And I can't think of a better person to receive it this year than Mike Rowe.
This is incredible. I'm honored, I'm flattered, I'm touched, I'm underdressed, I apologize. All my suits are rubber. I'm here tonight for the same reason that I have a career in television, and the reason is Freddie King. A lot of you know him, and I just had the great good fortune of walking into my high school, my 10th grade class, the same day he came to my high school to teach music. And it was a remarkable thing. He's a force of nature, as many of you know, and he grabbed me by the scruff of the neck, literally and figuratively, and he changed the trajectory of my life by introducing me to you knuckleheads. I mean, he forced me to join a quartet, and then he dragged me to the chorus of the Chesapeake. He was getting the chorus ready for a contest, and he asked a great question. And I'll ask you, how many people are here in the skilled trades? How many plumbers are here? Any plumbers at all? There's a couple. Electricians, a couple there. Bricklayers, steam fitters, mechanics, pipe fitters. This is what Fred would do when he talked to the chorus, and he would remind them that they could build a city. It wasn't about the music in that moment. It was about what they could do collectively, and I'll never forget that. Later that same night, I sat at a little square table with three guys I'd never seen before. One of them had a silver star, the other two had purple hearts. Korea and the Second World War. I was 17, and I sat there learning Roses of Picardy, a song I'd never heard, but by the end of the night, I did. That was barbershop to me. And it ultimately, it brought me here, and it's just extraordinary. And this is a real privilege. And I'm going to stand here and talk and sing another one until somebody takes me off the stage. Because why wouldn't I? Thank you so much. Thank you.